Hey guys, it's Keith, and welcome to our first ever sponsored video, Five Nights at Freddy's 4. Not sponsored by the game developers, sponsored by Patreon backer Seth Kanes or Jesse Miller. Because he donated to a certain tier, he gets once a month to request an hour-long episode of any game he wants. And there's a few people that are pledging for next month to do the same thing, so there'll be a few more of that soon. But here it is. It just had to start here, didn't it? All right, Five Nights at Freddy's 4. I have an idea of how the first three games go, kind of. Never played one myself. I've seen a friend play one of them in person. We'll see how this goes. I'm sure I'll do great. 5 days until the party. Hey, Golden Freddy. Do I control you? What did you do this time? What did he do this time? He locked you in your room again. Don't be scared. I am here with you. Oh, lordy. Am I playing? OWASD. I'm a crying child in a room. Looks like there's Foxy with a head with no head. Freddy, Chica, and what's the rabbit? Bonnie? The rabbit's name is Bonnie. And it's Golden Freddy. He's looking at me. All right, that's a good place to start. I'm psyched. So I'm crying, and I've got a live teddy bear. So I'm playing Among the Sleep. Okay, I played that game. That game's not even scary. I'll be fine. All right, so obviously you have to go through this door, right? What else could I possibly do here? Oh, there's knocking noises. I don't want to go. Do I have to? There's noises. Oh, someone's at the front door. What do I do? Do I go into this Foxy? Do I have to hit enter or something? It's not going through the door. Oh, shit. I just collapsed and started crying now? I didn't do anything. Tomorrow is another day. What? Sweet. Night one. Okay, I've heard this game's very different from the other Five Nights at Freddy's games, and I don't know what I'm getting myself into. Okay, cool. Flick the mouse downward to turn and look behind you. Close the doors, hold shift, use flashlight, hold control. Press X to hide tips. Flick it downward to look behind me. Click here to run to the door. Or I can run to that door. So how do I know which ones I want to look at? Oh no, I'm a little kid that fucking crawls around like a crazy person. Oh! This is some finicky controls. Okay. Do I have to? Alright, there's nothing there. I can close it, but I can... It opens back up. These are dumb doors. Get better doors, lady. Guy. Person. Whatever you are. Alright. Hit. Warning, listen carefully. If you hear breathing, hold the door shut. If you do not hear breathing, then use your flashlight. Okay. I don't hear breathing. Is there any reason not to close the door? So I'm just checking doors over and over again, I guess. No breathing. Am I just running between three doors over and over again? Is that the whole game now? I don't know. I don't know what to expect here. My understanding is that in Five Nights at Freddy's, each of the... Look behind me. Hey, Freddy. I don't have a flashlight meter so far. That's a good sign. Hello. Alright. We'll see how this goes. No breathing. I'll go ahead and get rid of the tooltips. I've spent enough time with them on screen to know what they do. There's only two buttons, shift and control. I guess I'll just keep checking. This is gonna be like one of those SCP games, like that one with the staircase where it's like nothing happens for so long that it just becomes scary because I'm waiting for so long for something to happen and then out of nowhere, surprise happens. I'm not ready for it. Alright, well, we're 5 minutes-ish in to my 1 hour sponsored video. of Five Nights at Freddy's 4, the final chapter. Funnily enough, it's called the final chapter, but it's going to have, apparently, first of all, who's this crazy child that's running around between three doors for like 8 hours at night? Don't hear breathing still. I feel like I have to keep checking all the doors or like something's going to sneak up on me. I'll also probably keep quiet every time I approach a door to hear. No sounds yet. Alright. But it's called Final Chapter. But this is going to have DLC around Halloween, is my understanding. Alright, well. I wonder if this game's going to scare me at all. Like when an actual jump scare happens. Because I played the first 5 minutes of Freddy's. We had no idea what we were getting ourselves into. We played the first one on Sad Games when it first came out. Because on that channel, we just play shitty indie games all the time. Okay. How you guys doing? Being creeping babies. Alright, cool. You do you, I'll do me, it's fine. That tensed a little mere moment. I wasn't scared, but I definitely was like, huh! Like, I got a little bit of, like, goosebumps on my arms from that one. Alright. God bless you for sticking with me if you're actually still watching. And you're not Seth Kane's. No breathing. I think it ends at 5 a.m. But yeah, on Sad Games, we just play shitty indie games all the time on purpose. Because we like making fun of bad games, and this just looked like another bad game. So we took a look. First of all, why are you all here? Go away, assholes. Am I supposed to scare them away? Do I, like, specifically not want them to build up on my bed like they're going to do something if they do? Still don't hear any breathing. I should be almost there. Who's a creepy baby? I'm a sexy little baby. I'm sorry, that's a Danny Sexbane from Game Grumps. Alright. Am I gonna make it to the first night on my first try? Now that there's been a threat so far. Who's a creepy baby? Something else is gonna happen and that's gonna freak me out, huh? It's like, oh, it's just some stupid chill. It's like some stupid bears. I got this, but then it's like I'll turn around once. And it's like, now it's a giant bear. Now it's your mom. I haven't heard breathing yet, which makes me nervous because I'm like, I don't know what it sounds like in this game yet. So like, I'm still in that. It's like a hearing test. Ooh, I made it. That's not how clocks work. That's not how clocks work at all. Yeah, I'm partly concerned of like. Like in a hearing test where you're like, am I hearing it or not hearing it? Because I could be imagining the sound at some point. 4 days until the party. You seem to have bad parties, dude. You know he is hiding again. Who's hiding? Oh, the door's open. That's a good sign. That's great. Oh, hey, creepy baby. We won't stop until we find him. Okay. Just gonna start walking around. This is actually a little creepier. The bear is creepy, first of all. Stop it. That door is blocked. What about over here? Over there. What's over here? Something gonna happen when I walk away? What about over... It's over here? Okay, you got me. That's not... There's just some asshole behind the fucking TV. Tomorrow's another day. Who's this asshole? That's just like... I'm gonna hang out behind a TV and just put on a creepy thing. Fun with push trap. Hold control to use flashlight. Use flashlight to stop push trap. What? Hey, creepy. Was there other controls? I didn't finish reading. I was cut off guard by the description. Hey, creepy. Who's a creepy baby? Wait, do I have a reason to stop? Seizure warning. Too late. Am I supposed to do something? I didn't finish reading the instructions in time. I didn't know they were going to go away on me like that. So all I know is that here's push trap. You're supposed to use the flashlight. They're fucking with me. God damn it. God damn it. Any moment now, it's one of the times I press it, something's going to happen. We're halfway out of time. What if I just sit here for a while and do nothing? How badly could they scare me? Dun dun. Dun dun. Oh, he's coming at- What? Oh, fuck you. He was moving. He's like running around in the darkness. Am I supposed to do something? I don't want it. I don't want it. 12 seconds. Just go faster, please. Just go faster. Am I supposed to catch him when he's on the X? Is that what's going on here? Is this a mini game or is this part of the main game or too bad? Okay, I guess it didn't matter. I guess it was a mini game, so who cares? I think I was supposed to catch him with the flashlight when he was on the X, is probably what the rest of the instructions said. But if the game continues, I guess we're okay. This guy really does like his like weird pre-rendered 3D models. No breathing. But yeah, on sad games, we just like to play bad games on purpose. And this just looked like another shitty indie game getting through Steam Greenlight, so we didn't know what we were getting ourselves into. No breathing. And we didn't like it, actually. Like, not at all, really. The initial premise was creepy, but then it just turned into a waiting game. Who's a creepy little baby? Alright. It kind of turned into a waiting game, which it is right now. And at some point, if it's not scary... I heard a noise. I don't know if that sound was what I think it was, though. This is probably better, in my opinion. I think I like this more than the camera thing. Because the camera thing was annoying to me because you had to look around so much. And once I started hearing about how the AIs work, I just kind of got annoyed at the game. Of all the weird patterns you have to do to beat the game using the weird camera controls. Who's your creepy bear? Oh, he's adorable. He's a... Oh, I don't want it. Go away. Okay, you got me. Where's my headphones? Like, it came like half off. Okay, so now the continue mark. We're only 1/4 of the way through the hour. I'm going to lose my mind. Alright, that's a long time to spend looking at doors. Alright. See, that's what someone sounds like when they actually get jump scared. It's very different from the hilarious screaming that famous YouTubers do, where they, like, make funny Jim Carrey faces at their webcam. And they scream at the top of their lungs and make weird and unintelligible noises. No. So I wonder if I was supposed to hold the door closed for longer? Or if... I don't know. First of all, that's going to be fucked if someone's in my closet. Because like, it's not like they're going to go somewhere else. Don't hear any breathing. I still haven't really heard breathing, necessarily. I'm unsure about the audio in this game. If I was supposed to hear breathing back then. Maybe the idea is I was supposed to just hear it coming. Maybe that's it. That's not nice. Ow. Ow. My ears. I'm not hearing the breathing. I'm hearing the fucking jump scare for sure. Alright. Here we go. You did this to me, Seth Kanes. You paid money to do this to me. You monster. Oh, don't crash on me, you fuck. I'd be very disappointed in you. Where am I right now? Oh. Alright. Running around at the speed of sound. Yeah, we got the worst possible non-jump scare ending when we played. Where we died on the first night, but we died because we ran out of power because the game didn't explain how power worked in time. Who's a creepy guy? The game's failing to load properly, which is kind of indicating that something special might happen when I go up to stuff. Okay. This is... the repetition is starting to set in. Alright. I wonder if it'll come through... like, I'll probably compress the audio, so maybe... there's hearing you guys can... maybe there's breathing you guys can hear that I can't. I don't know. It's so loud, I'd be afraid to turn it up more, because, like, it's actually hurting my ears when the jump scares happen, so... I don't know if I want to make the game even louder. I can't say I'm scared. It's just that it's like... I do physically jump when the loud noise plays, because that's how loud noises happen. Like when you have an irritating sibling that runs up behind you and like shakes your shoulders like, "Oh, I made you jump. You're so scared." It's like, no, you fucking did something loud or hit, like, struck me. I'll say that the doll sitting in the hallway was pretty creepy when I was trying to figure out what to do there. What if I just close it? What are you gonna do about it, huh? What are you gonna do about it? But yeah, I'm not super psyched about some of this stuff. I don't know. I think one of the issues I have with Five Nights at Freddy's, and it's not necessarily a knock against the game, it's just why I don't have an interest in it, is that the video game mechanics are abstract.
Hey, little baby.
Chill. I don't like you. I don't like you. Why? You're being mean now. Ooh, look at the creepy crocodile faces. Who's your creepy crocodile faces all over the loading screen? But yeah, one of the things that turns me off about Five Nights at Freddy's is that it's got abstract game mechanics. Like, in Amnesia, for example, you want to get somewhere, and the bad guy is coming, so you better hide from the bad guy, and you gotta run past the bad guy and use stealth mechanics and try to get to your goal. In every Five Nights at Freddy's game, you sit in one room and just kind of hang out all day and try to not get killed, but like the reasons that they're not killing you is like weird AI patterns of them teleporting around and doing whatever. At some point it's kind of like, eh. It's just the game mechanics are abstract in a way that I don't necessarily appreciate or have a lot of interest in following up on. So when the game's like, so you gotta click on that, like when you watch, like I've seen Markiplier play a game before, and I just skipped to episode night 5 with no context to see what it was like, and he was like, I gotta click there, and light, alright, camera, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, 2, and then you gotta click, flashlight, oh, tune the music box, and it's like, I'm like, this is a bunch of random nonsensical actions. Who's your creepy baby? And at some point, it's just like, I don't know what's going on. It's like watching someone play StarCraft. But that's the whole game. Like, at least in StarCraft, the base mechanics are like, oh, I understand what's going on. You make dudes. And you send them around. And you go kill the bad guys. And then when you see a professional player, it's like, oh, okay, now I have no idea what's going on. Still don't hear breathing. No. Behind me.
Who's your creepy bear? Who's your creepy bear?
Who's your creepy bear? I'm gonna hold this door closed for a while now because you're creepy. Like when you watch, like StarCraft starts out making sense, and then as you go further, it stops making sense because people get so good at it. But Five Nights, like one night in, I'm already like, I don't really like. There's not the mechanics aren't really intuitive to me, but also kind of don't have an interest in progressing past that point. How long do I hold the door closed? What happens? What the fuck is that? Do I die now? I don't. I don't know if I can do this for a whole hour. I think I'm already reaching my limit on this one. Alright, so Five Nights at Freddy's didn't go so great. Funnily enough, I just realized the coincidence here. I'll get to that in a minute, but thankfully, the guy, Seth Kane's / Jesse, he happened to have another game lined up for me to play, which is good because I'd be willing to keep playing for a full hour, but I just got the feeling like, oh no, based on these 20 minutes and like the way I'm starting to just die the same way over and over again, like the next 40 minutes of this video are gonna suck, aren't they? Like I could, if I went for a full hour on Five Nights at Freddy's 4, I think everyone was just gonna be miserable. But, funnily enough, another game for the furry community has been selected. Dust and Elysian Tale. This one has slightly less creepy connotations in that community. Whoa. Weird. Okay, this is interesting. Oh, now it's kind of fixed itself. Okay, there was a weird thing where I was skipping past help every time I pressed it down, and it was on the D-pad, which is like, we at least expect that to happen. But this is actually a pretty neat little game. I'll do a quick look just to see if, oh, there's colorblind mode. That's a nice touch. Congratulations, guys. HUD. Let's go ahead and scale that. Oh, whoa. You can manually relocate. Oh my goodness, that's impressive. You can manually relocate and resize pieces of the HUD. That's pretty great. Wow, I did not know that these features were in the game. They might have not been in this game last time I played it, which was when it first launched on 360. I'm playing it on the PlayStation 4 because it was actually a PlayStation Plus game at some point. I just realized my mistake. I was like, I'm going to go look for subtitles. I don't need to turn on subtitles in this game. You do zoomed-in character portrait conversations. It has autosaving. I understand that. Don't need to read that. So you can play as casual, normal, tough. Hardcore. Is this the one where you die forever? Let's go ahead and play tough mode.
Our world has fallen to fade. Its great works long since complete. Its storied civilizations long since fallen to dust. The greatest legends of Elysium long since forgotten. What was once a land of promise has fallen to the ravages of war. And it was in this, our most desperate hour, that the greatest of Elysian tales began. The lone warrior stood against an army, slashing his way through all who opposed him. The mob stood no chance, and the soldier showed no mercy. But despite his victories, his skills, his ruthlessness, the valiant soldier would perish on this day. Not to the mob, but to a single child.
Dust, dust, arise.
A talking sword. What are you?
Only that which you have summoned.
Summoned? How? For what purpose?
That I do not know. But we shall learn in time. Now rise and claim the Blade of Ahrah.
she?
Me? I'm Fidget, guardian of the sword.
No offense, but aren't you a bit, well, small? For a guardian, I mean.
Hey, I just look after that thing. After 200 years, nobody expects the sword to just fly off and start, you know, talking. I'm kind of wishing somebody told me this was part of the job description. Or maybe they did, and I just wasn't paying attention. Yeah, that happens sometimes.
I'm sorry, I think I misheard before. You said your name was Fidget?
Hey, this isn't about me. You're the one who's got my sword. How about you tell me your name?
Calm yourself, Fidget. His name is Dust, and he is the one who woke me from my slumber.
So, Fidget, then?
That's me, and you're Dust?
It would seem that way, though I can't recall that name. So, what is this sword?
I am the Blade of Ahrah, and you, Dust, are my fated sword-bearer.
Yes, well, that's all great and everything, but I think it's about time I got this sword back to the clan.
I can't let you just leave with this sword, Fidget. Right now, it's the only thing that knows who I am. I don't even know how I got here.
Well, then you leave me no choice. I challenge you! The winner gets the sword!
Well, I...
all right, you win. But don't think I'm leaving empty-handed. I'm coming with you. But, I really need the sword back when you're done doing... you know, whatever it is you're doing.
What exactly am I doing, Ahrah?
The answers you seek lie to the east. There is a path through the glade that leads down the mountainside, and from there you will find a village. That is your first step.
Then will you give me the sword? I really need to get it back home before anyone notices it's gone.
When I find out just what it is I'm supposed to do with it, it's all yours, Fidget. Come on, let's go.
So this game is pretty mind-blowing because it's actually made by one person. Like, that's it. One guy made this whole game, basically. Obviously, it has a voice cast. Don't be a smartass. All the voice actors are different people. Aside from the usual trends of this, probably some duplicated voice acting, because that's how voice acting generally works. But yeah, the voices are not all done by the guy that made the game, but he made basically everything else. He programmed it, he designed it, he stuck with it for years, and then he worked in conjunction with Microsoft, I believe, to get it out on Xbox 360, and they sort of published it at first, but now it's kind of made its way to other platforms. And it's really... it's a pretty damn impressive game. Like, as far as indie stuff goes, like, it's just a really high-quality sort of Metroidvania questy RPG kind of game that you can play. And you can easily go through it without ever thinking that it was made by one person. Unlike... which is actually an interesting coincidence, because, yeah, on top of the... I made a crack about furry stuff a moment ago, but we also were just playing Five Nights at Freddy's. Another game made by one person, and that's a game that very much does feel like it's made by one person. So I have quick attacks with square, and triangle attacks are more, sort of a power attack more. But there's different ways things that'll happen. So like this is square attacks, and by default nothing happens with triangle. But if I begin with square and go to triangle, it does a launch, sort of Metroidvania. I mean, sort of a Castlevania style. I can do this exact move you've seen me do with Dante over and over again. There's a few different ways you can end combos here. It's interesting. It's much like... It has somewhat of a feel of, like, these games tend to be button mashy.
What is it, Fidget?
Well, my kind has what you'd call a sixth sense. And there's something just ahead.
Fidget will alert you when treasure's nearby. Click R3 to access the map. Welcome to the map. Yep, this is where you start getting that Shadow Complex Metroid sort of grid-based map where... up and down don't represent north and south, but literally up and down vertically on the map, which is interesting. Can I drop through here? I don't seem to have the ability to right now. Oopsie, I just healed myself on accident. That's what I get for experimenting with buttons. Dash acquired. Now we can do this, which seems like a kind of a big deal to have. Look, I can dodge now like a person. That'll be a big deal. Maybe now it'll let me drop down, since I don't think I can go forward that way. Yep, there we go. But yeah, this game has a bit of a more to it in the combat you'd expect, because this kind of genre tends to play more like a Castlevania game, where it's like you just, oh, like here's your weapon, here's your attack button, and that's how melee combat works forever. Wall chicken. Speaking of Castlevania, note added: here you can view active and completed quests, as well as any notes you picked up. In ancient times, our greatest possessions and staunchest allies were locked away using powerful magic beyond our comprehension. The only way to reclaim these lost treasures is to use the magically attuned keys strewn about our world. I only hope there's enough time to free them all. Hello, treasure chest.
All right, we found a chest!
Correction, we found a locked chest.
Well, what are you waiting for? Smash it open.
That would be unwise, Dust. These chests are protected by arcane locks from the last era, and are well beyond my capabilities.
I suppose we'll need a key, then.
What a coincidence. I think I found a key earlier. Oh, got hit up. Oh, we're doing one of these. Okay. I was just about to compare it to Dishwasher, and that's about as dishwasher as you get. So Dishwasher Dead Samurai is a game that also follows the sort of Metroidvania feel of like the side-scrolling beat-em-up. Actually, that's not a Metroidvania, that's just a side-scrolling beat-em-up. But it's interesting because it's a genre you normally will just button-mash through. But this game and Dishwasher both have more of a like Devil May Cry-style extensive combo set that you usually expand over time, which adds a nice satisfying feel to the combat. I'm a little puzzled by the fact that we're animal people and there are also animals here. I guess that shouldn't make that little sense to me. In real life, like, humans are animal people. Unless you object to...
Calm yourself, Fidget. Dust. Focus. Remember what you've learned thus far.
No! Mash the buttons! Do something!
Monsters? That's racist. But, Unless you don't believe in evolution or something, under that concept, people are animals, animal people too, I guess. So it's not that crazy. Like, oh look, there's normal creatures, and now there's crazy humanoid creatures.
Nobody said anything about monsters.
Strange. Where did I learn these skills?
You wield the Blade of Ahrah, and with it, all the skills imbued therein.
Hello? Monsters?
Is that why I summoned you? To control this power?
It is unlikely, Dust, that I would awaken from my slumber for such selfish reasons. There is a village beyond these woods. Perhaps finding it will aid in restoring your memories.
And then we'll be in the clear, right? No more monsters?
Fidget, I think things are about to get a whole lot worse.
To think, this morning started off so well. At least take these people fruits. Something tells me you're gonna need them.
Gaining experience, exploring, all the good things. It's funny because this game seems... Oh, save point. Those are a big deal. I forgot that this game has manual saves. Or I guess it looks like it does also have autosave happening. We're now 3% complete with the game, although... I bet that some of that's a little front-loaded with the easy progression at the beginning. But, hello, friends. They want me... They're starting to teach me specific combos now. Square, 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 square. There we go. Hey, buddies. You're making me lose track of the things I'm trying to talk about, you sillies. Oh, right. Our evade is a big deal. Should be using that. I specifically chose a harder difficulty, and here I am not even invading... There we go. You want to come up to the sky with me? Yay! Up here with me! Oh, I was pressing the wrong button. That's what I was trying to do. I was forgetting to press down when I was trying to do my down attack. Which kind of defeats the purpose a bit. I love that little kick where I catch them on my foot and then just slam them. That's a great little moment. Howdy, y'all. Oh, it's even listed as a throw. Okay, it's called Ashbound. Hey, friends.
Yeah.
I think I'm destroying them. Don't alarm anyone, but they're getting wrecked. So when do I get magic? Oh, that's what I was trying to get at, is, I've played some of this game before. Never got around to playing all the way through it. I don't know what interrupted me there. Honestly, it's probably Let's Play related stuff. I think I'd already started at that point. Once you start Let's Playing, it gets a lot harder to just play games on your own time. Ever. But this, it's funny because this game's so colorful and seems cutesy and everything, but my understanding is that the story is ultimately about, like, war crimes and genocide. So, you know, happy things. There we go. Go back to where you came from, buddy.
Yeah.
You guys come after me? Oh, that's a horrible noise. What the hell? I think something just went horribly wrong with the audio mixing, because I just heard the loudest possible freaking chipmunk noise in my ears. Like, it... For you guys, it's compressed, so it probably doesn't sound like that, but for me, it was like, holy crap, that's twice as loud as the rest of the game. That's freaking me out, man. Hey, buddy. Back down you go. It's kind of funny. Right now, they're establishing this really complicated... I mean, not that complicated. It's only a few moves, but a fairly extensive melee system. Once you start using magic, though... You kind of stop using combos. It becomes a lot less likely that you'll actually use them against anyone, because spamming magic seems to be the most intelligent way to play this game. I think that's my first spell right there.
Audienced. You have unlocked a new ability. Bear witness to the dust storm.
Yeah.
I like it. Hold the secondary attack to perform the dust storm, but beware. Skilled as you may be, you cannot maintain the storm for long without hurting yourself.
In that case, maybe I can help. If you press the super ballistic fidget action button of power, I'll perform an attack so spectacularly awesome that it'll produce emotions you didn't even know existed. Please contain yourselves as I demonstrate.
That was, very pretty.
Well, maybe I'll just keep the rest of my repertoire to myself.
I'm sorry, Fidget. I'm sure it'll come in handy somehow.
Actually, Dust, between the three of us, this could be quite useful. The Dust Storm can manipulate Fidget's projectile into a more powerful attack. Observe.
Every time I use my power, it'll use up a bit of energy meter. You can recharge the meter with melee combos.
Yes, Dust. Between your combos and Fidget's own powers, you can achieve a higher hit chain, which will yield bonus experience after each battle. However, if you are struck by an enemy, the chain will be broken, and you will lose your bonus experience.
All right, I think I understand.
If this is all too much for you, you can check out the help screen via the pause menu.
Thanks, Fidget. I'll take a look if I'm ever in trouble.
Here we go. So yeah, I think you get an idea of what I was talking about when I said that magic becomes kind of a big deal in this game. So getting an idea of what's going on here. You notice that I start turning red as I do this power attack. If I keep going after I start turning red, what's going to happen is that I'm actually going to... I'll be in danger of hurting myself if I keep going at that point as I turn red like that.
Magic!
Yeah, the humming is pretty extensive. Buddy, come on, get back in the fight. Don't hang out there. You're not even in the combat zone anymore. Just hiding behind awkward little maces.
Kick!
There's not a lot stopping me from just doing that all the time, frankly. It's also just fun to do the spinning attack even when I'm not using magic, just because it's such a powerful, crazy AoE-looking thing. Looks pretty badass. Of course they would call it the Dust Storm. I guess it makes sense. It's just another one of those things that's like surprisingly cutesy in a game that is not going to be so cutesy in its story and theming, despite it being like, my name's Dust, this is my attack, Dust Storm! Hello, friends. I'm trying to remember what the game's name is called, actually. It's Dust and Elysian Tale. And I think they might have done even something cutesy there where they called it Dust and Elysian Tail, as in like a tail, like the one that goes on your butt, and not a story, which is kind of a funny way of going with it. Because they have tails, get it? Genocide. Attack! Oh, you hit me. Shit, my bad. I kind of let that happen. There we go. Just need to sort of maintain more of a front where I'm more aware of what's in front of me and who's approaching. Hey, friend. Oh, he's out of my range. Excuse me, sir. You just get a little closer to where I ruin you. Make me feel better about myself. Oh, you can dodge with the right stick also. Instead of just, let's try to heal. Is it L1? It is L1. Ow. Well, that goes half the health I just healed. Rude. Damage everywhere. There we go. How you guys doing? Feeling alright? Getting comfy? Hope so. Cause this is gonna be your earthly grave.
Hey, you just leveled up!
Is that what I did? It feels good. Great even.
As it should, Dust. You've acquired a skill gem. Open the character screen from the inventory to upgrade your abilities and become even more powerful.
Now we can choose between new stat. Whoa. Excuse me. Would you like 80 health or 180 health? Oh wow, all of these are actually going to go up a lot the first time I put points into them. Let's get me some health, because I'm noticing that I take a lot of damage pretty quickly. That's my only gem for now. Seems like a worthwhile first point. Welcome to your inventory. Don't have a lot of stuff to put on, really. Alright. So yeah, now I have really extensively higher health, which is kind of a big deal. This seemed like the best first approach to points. You can tell that they even show my number, they show my health as a fraction on the screen, pretty large. That's very much in tune with the usual Castlevania thing. That always threw me off when I ever go back to Symphony of the Night. I always forget that you don't have a health bar in that game, you just have a number. The bar is actually your magic meter, which is takes a while to get used to. Leap of faith. They chased and I ran. 5, maybe even 6 of them, all armed to the teeth and closing in fast. I made it to Archer's Pass, but with an arrow in my leg, they caught up with me at that headless statue. Surrounded, desperate, and nowhere else to go, I climbed out to the hand and made a leap of faith. Hello, friend.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised if that was some sort of hint about, like, if you go to the edge of the statue and jump, you'll get special loot or something. It would not be something that I put beyond this kind of game. But I do not have specific memories as to whether or not that is the case. I totally let that combo expire on accident just because I thought I was going to reach someone sooner than I actually did. There we go. Anyone else left to hit? Oh, no. Wasted attack. Hello, friend. Oh, yeah. You're quite vulnerable to a combo all on your own. Oh, wow. That's a whole bunch of them. Oh. Completely blew that magic spell. Got to more specifically follow up the magic spell right away with the spinning attack, or it's not going to amount to much. There we go. Like, more like that. Hey, friends. Oh, I was attacking no one. Very easy to get yourself clung into a combo, apparently. Hello, friend. Kick. So it's kind of funny during cutscenes, and even during gameplay right now, it's more apparent than it ever was before that, like when I played this on 360, I noticed that his sword was 3D while everything else in the game is pretty much all 2D, pretty obviously. Like, you can sort of notice that his sword is 3D from the way it moves, that it's actually a character model as opposed to a sprite. But what really threw me off, now that we're playing an even higher and crisper picture on PS4, I am really aware, like, especially during every single dialogue cutscene. Yep, that is absolutely a 3D sword in a 2D game, which is a bit of an adjustment to get used to the concept of. Enjoy that magic, buddy? It likes you. You better get comfy. I'm actually taking the time to carefully select, pick up gold, even though I'm just doing a little bit of a preview episode here, basically.
Wow. It's really beautiful up here.
Yeah. So, any idea where we are?
I was maybe hoping you could tell me.
Oh, silly me. I seem to have dropped all my detailed maps and navigational equipment chasing after a crazy flying sword.
I'm sorry I got you mixed up in this, Fidget.
Well, you should be. Taking my sword, getting me in trouble.
You know, now that I think about it, this isn't the first time I've seen this view. I've stood here before, in this very spot.
Then perhaps you recognize the village at the base of these cliffs?
It's hard to make out from here. We'll need to drop down to the valley floor if we want to get any closer.
Very well. Proceed as you wish, Dust.
I believe I will. Quest has been updated. I believe I can follow it, though, without checking individually. Wow, I really nailed it there, didn't I? Hey, buddy. Go on down there. But only on my leave. You don't get to do it on your own. You need permission. Ooh, that was a cool combo. So, let's do that. We'll do a launch. Oh, he died already. So much for that idea. Hey. Such frequent save points. And they appear to be auto-saving. Yeah, it looks like they do an automatic autosave every time I step on one of these. That's also handy of them to do. Let's try to get one of those aerial combos I just initiated done again, because that was a cool little moment. Oops. Guys. Oop, okay. Just trying to get them all on one side of me again, as a risk of being a surprise attack from behind there. Well, how's that working out for you guys? That's what I was going for. Yeah, that's fun. Oh. Works a lot better if they're actually caught in my combo. Is this guy semi-invisible? He's going translucent on me. Maybe it's because he was already dying. Wow, I'm really good at just beasting my way through walls. Ooh. Two wall chickens and two keys. It's my new favorite wall to destroy. Thank you. The wall chicken is very much a reference to old school Castlevanias. That's the wrong spot. Oh, dodging affects your magic meter. Good to know. Ooh, that was a pretty cool little moment. I deflected his attack and it actually had a special animation for it. Combo! It's good to combo them in midair because they can't fight back as much. A good safe moment for us. Hello, friends. That's not a destructible wall. As much as I would very much like them all to be. Yep, dodging definitely drains your meter quite a bit, actually. It's a good thing to keep out on. It encourages you to have better control of the battlefield so you don't have to actively dodge so much. For example, by trying to establish that everything's on one side. This game's trying to fucking jump scare me. What is up with that? It did it again where it played one sound that was weirdly louder than the entire sound mix. There might be a mistake in the port for that part. So, I might as well increase my... Wow, you can really increase your health still. I'm going to go for some attack, though. Because my attack's not great. Multiplying it by 2.5 is a pretty big deal. I'm sure it's a pretty good point. Pretty good idea just to get that first point into every stat point, because it's such a big increase from your level 1 stats. Probably want to put a point to Fidget, because that's what affects your magic powers and stuff, which are definitely a very powerful part of this game. Hey, friends. Nice to meet you here. I'm glad you could all come. Now you die. There we go. Just maintaining control of the battlefield, as you're meant to. I think they're all dead now. Alright. That went relatively cleanly. Wow, he was way up in the sky. Did he just fall down? Can I break that? Let's check real quick. Nope. I could almost hit them through it. What's his power? New ability. Press triangle mid-jump to fly through the air and target enemies from afar. Ooh, I remember you. What's cool about that attack is that it's, as you can guess from the name, it's called Aerial Dust Storm, which means that it does the same thing as your normal... So I can do this, basically. So I can do, I have the ability to trigger magic's crazy effects in midair, which makes me pretty goddamn badass honestly. You turn into a spinning midair battle mage, which is pretty effective. At some point, there's a fire spell that creates pillars of flame, which makes it very effective for that particular purpose. Hello, friends. Oh, yeah, they're very dead. Which is really just an excuse for the game to throw way harder stuff at me soon. It's like, oh, what's that? You think you've got these guys now? Well, we'll prove you wrong. Let's grab these resources they're dropping. Down you go! Woohoo! I will say it's a little finicky with its controls in that it's actually the more dust storm abilities you unlock, the harder it is to just do normal attacks anymore. Because it gets really easy to accidentally trigger dust storm whenever you press triangle to do other combos. So according to Fidget, there's nearby treasure. Let's keep our eye open. Oh, there it is. Found it. As it turns out. But yeah, the way that you open treasures definitely cements my earlier comparison to dishwasher. Ooh, 2 attack and 2 luck. I'll take it. Especially since it's a blank slot anyway. I think we need to get the fire magic and trigger it here to get through that. So that's for way later. That's where the Metroidvania stuff starts coming in, where you explore a map and you know, there's specific stuff you have to come back with certain powers later to get through.
Is there somebody in there?
Whatever it is, it's got glowing eyes of evil.
A merchant lies in wait. Do not let his appearance frighten you. I sense he only wishes to assist in our journey.
Psh, I wasn't frightened. Just surprised at the, savings. Come on, let's get in.
Let's talk to the creepy merchant. You like those glowing eyes? They're great.
I've been expecting you, stranger.
Who are you?
Merely a friend with many wares for sale. Shall we conduct business?
Cool, lizard people. I'm sure he's safe. We have pendants to pick from. I already have a pendant, so I'll look at something else. Let's look at armor. 1 defense, 2 defense, 4 defense, and 1 luck. Oh, and it only costs 160. That's pretty good. Let's grab one of those. What about rings? 1 defense, 2 luck? Let's grab one. And you also sell treasure keys, but they're really expensive. And you sell upgrade materials and stuff like that. I'll focus on just filling in the slots I don't have yet.
Before you leave, might I propose an offer?
That would depend on the offer.
If I may be so bold, you are not prepared for the journey ahead. I, however, can offer assistance. Please, accept this blueprint as a gift. Should you find a blacksmith and the necessary materials, they may be able to craft the item for you. I can offer you materials as well, though I'm not entirely sure what materials this land deems of value. I am not from around here, as I'm sure you've guessed by now. Once you've sold me a new material type, I will be able to restock my store with it. As for your reward, I will pay you a bonus for the first new material you sell me.
Ah, you'll buy them at a high price.
Yes, I will.
Thank you.
Watch your back, my friend.
A lizard man told me to watch my back. I don't know if I feel good about this. So a new venture. Mysterious merchant has asked you to find various materials, blah, blah, blah. Don't need to go too detailed on that. He just explained that to me anyway. Let's go ahead and equip my new equipment. Ooh. Light chainmail. It's a blueprint for 10 defense and 1 luck. We need all these things. All right. I'll equip my item that actually exists first. And ring. 1 defense, 2 luck. Only have 1 ring, though. So the augments actually affect the sword itself, which is interesting. Maybe I should investigate that, actually.
I am here to serve.
So 1 attack, 2 attack, 6 attack. 6. Is it temporary or permanent? I actually don't remember. I've actually kind of forgotten how augments work in this game. Like, if they just happen right away, or if they're like a temporary boost. Either way, my stats are significantly higher than they were a moment ago. So that's handy. We'll just proceed accordingly. I'd prefer to at least... Let's see. This wall is reinforced by a powerful ally. Something explosive would do the trick. I do not have anything explosive. Well, I sh- just to establish really quick that that's not how that works. We need a fire version of that, basically. But yeah, I'd like to at least get to town before we stop this. A bomb fruit? Oh. Is this the explosive thing? How do I set you off? Oh, there we go. Okay, I was wrong. I thought it was the fire thing that I had to use. Maybe that also does it, or maybe I am stupid. I am very frequently wrong about things, as you are sure to know. Whee! So let's see if I can get... We've already established there was one back there. Let's see if I can get this to go all the way back there. Come with me! This is where it really comes in handy that I can do the mid-air spin. Because otherwise I'd have to keep stopping to do it. Oh, here we go. So what's back here? Another key. Very handy to have. I love that even in the game it's called Mysterious Wall Chicken. That's the same reference. I should play Castle... I need to get around to playing some Castlevania games on this channel at some point. It is one of my favorite things to play. I've never been a super fan of Castlevania in that I don't have a... Oh, right, I'm supposed to go up here. In that I haven't played a completionist amount of the games, and I haven't been like a super fan of like super like dedicated to the story and remembering everything, and I don't know, but they're just games I really enjoy, and I've played Symphony of the Night several times over at this point. Wouldn't mind having a PS4 copy of that game. Unfortunately, that does not exist. You have to download it as a classic on PS3 or 360, or just have it as a PS1 game if you're either rich or never got rid of your original copy. I'm sure that's not the cheapest game to get nowadays. Like getting the original Metal Gear as an original PS1 copy instead of some sort of weird re-release. Thankfully, the new generation made that a lot easier for us. So they keep re-releasing things as like $8 downloads and stuff instead of the high price you have to pay for a disc. I need to stop dodging around. I keep dodging because it's just kind of fun to do that animation sometimes. But then I remember a moment later, oh, right, that cost me something. Oh, wow, that guy was way up there. I'm sorry. I mean, sorry, not sorry, you know. I'm giving you the courtesy of pretending to be sorry. Yeah, that's what happens, is that they get so up there and stay in the air for so long because my combo is actually carrying them for a long time. The magic is... Howdy, y'all. Come here. In the air with you. Ooh, there was something up there.
Dust, there's something up there.
Not a problem at all. Stand back. All right, I've got it. Wait, no! Ah.
Having some trouble there?
Yeah, I don't know. I just can't get a good enough grip.
Aw, you're just trying to show off. That's sweet. Don't worry about it. I'm sure there's a way to get up there. We'll just come back later.
Another hint at future abilities we'll have that can help me get onto that kind of place. Oh, actually the first hint, because it's the thing that I previously referred to as being a hint, was actually me being just dead wrong about stuff. It happens. Oh, chain broke. Oh, wow, I'm taking damage. That's unfortunate. I'll have to actually heal. I think I did some damage. Oh, what is he? Whoa. What is he? Was he shooting me with something that I wasn't making out? Let's just focus on magic for this guy for a bit. I have the magic to spend. Let's just avoid being in range of him for a while. So apparently that blob does some serious damage. This thing's not dying very quickly, is it? Wow. It is out to get me. Oh, there we go. Took like a 100-hit combo. Wow. That was a hazard. Whatever that eyeball blob monster was. Hello, dear. So this is where you ran off to. You got here safely. Weird.
Looks like we're heading in the right direction.
Be on your guard, Dust. I sense a powerful foe ahead of you.
Don't worry, Dust. I'll be behind you every step of the way. Way behind. Ah, it's another one of those spiky slime things!
They're persistent, I'll give them that.
Much as I pity this corrupted beast, now might be a good time to demonstrate the parry technique. Allow it to strike.
Hey!
Attack and hold the button at the moment of the enemy's strike, and you will parry their attack, opening them up for a counterattack. Timing is crucial, and you must be facing your opponent. And as you can see, a successful parry may also daze your opponent temporarily. Now, put this beast out of its misery.
Well, that's neato. That's the ability I did on accident earlier. Well, he went down fast. Seems to make you very powerful, indeed.
I see somebody over there.
Ask them if they've got anything to eat.
We're in a bit of a hurry, Fidget. Don't worry, I'll feed you later.
Hey, I'm not a pet! But, I would appreciate that. Thanks.
Huh. I wonder if they changed the game structure or not. I could have sworn I fought a big tree monster or something along the way here. I don't necessarily remember the slime creatures, but I could just be completely misremembering the structure at the beginning of this game. Or this could be like a new console generation, like equivalent of the game. This is great. Alright. Hello, Care Bear.
Oh, hello! You surprised me there. Don't get many travelers this far out of town.
Sorry about that. It's nice to finally meet a friendly face. So we're getting closer to the village, then?
You mean Aurora Village?
Yes. It's just beyond those fields to the east. And I think you might be just in time.
What do you mean?
The monster attacks down there have been getting worse. Right before you showed up, I'd swear I heard somebody shouting.
She's right, Dust. I can hear somebody calling for help further down the path.
Let's get going.
Yes, please hurry. Be careful.
Gotta go. Lives to be saved, apparently. Where are they at? Maybe this is where the fight is that I was thinking about. Hello, save. Oh, so on other difficulty levels, you actually get healed by save points. I figured that'd be the case. It's just because I'm playing on tough mode that we're not having that happen. Oh, yeah, I think this is where the fight actually is that I was talking about earlier. Nope, there he is.
Look at the size of that thing!
Don't worry, I think I can handle it.
Exercise all you've learned, Dust. Send these foul creatures from this existence.
He seems friendly. I'm just gonna spam magic for a little bit here and see how much I can do with it. Alright, I'm kind of out of it now. Hello, Big Nasty. Just gonna avoid getting stuck in his attacks if I can. Because he will totally ruin me. But the magic can help me. Quite a bit, actually. Holy crap. Oh, and I got hit by a combo. Yep. Let's avoid attacking him one-on-one like that if I can. Oh, crap. Wow, a lot of things will get me hit like that. Definitely want to fight with magic on this one. Especially since I'm out of healing items altogether now. There we go. How's that for some damage? Get out! Oh, crap. That was me trying to dodge. I really screwed that up. Yep. I remember this going roughly this way the first time, too, where the first fight just kind of kicks your ass a bit. Just because he can almost one-shot you. He stops just short of killing you at one hit point. I don't know if that's because that you can't lose or because it's just one of those things that doesn't kill you in one hit.
No, wait! That's not all of them!
Here comes some more!
Oh, God, me. Really? Is that necessary to have two? Howdy, folks. God damn, that combo counter, though. It's just happy to be here. It's happy to be working. Holy crap. Did I accidentally scroll it off the screen too much? Was that my mistake? Holy crap. Still, though, this is about as easy as it gets, probably. The fact that I can just kind of combo through them like this. I don't see anything stopping me, necessarily. Just gotta make sure that I don't do it into one of their attacks that they started when I previously went by. Yeah, this is mostly just gonna let me win. It's the type of game where they try to overwhelm you with more enemies, more so than having a super tough one-on-one fight for the most part. Although I think there are some interesting, like, Mega Man-style semi-gimmicky boss fights where there's, like, a thing the boss does you have to worry about. These big dumb golem things, though, aren't really here to be a problem. The primary threat comes from just attacking you among other enemies.
Is that it? Did we get all of them?
Yeah, I think that's it.
Well done, Dust. You have proven yourself a worthy swordsmaster, and none too soon.
Bah, they weren't so tough. I could probably take on another 4 or 5 of them. You know, if I had to. And Dust was there.
Oh, thank you so much.
What happened here?
I don't know. We were out here checking the fields when those giants attacked.
We've been having a lot of problems with smaller beasts, but this is the first time a giant has ever come this close to the village.
Then the first step of your journey is near its end, Dust. The village lies just ahead.
Yes, we arrived. That's great. But what now?
That has not yet been revealed to me. These people are safe, and that is what is important. Let us continue onward.
Will you two be all right?
Yes. I just need a moment to rest. I'm not sure how you did it, but you took down 3 giants single-handedly.
Not a problem. That's what we do. Bringing justice to the weak and defenseless.
Hey! Who are you calling weak?
I'm gonna leave now. Don't mind me. Don't get mad at me for my stupid sidekick insulting random people. I need hit points. Dear Lord. Alrighty, guys, so this has been Dust, an Elysian Tale. I hope you guys have enjoyed my first sponsored video on the channel.
Hold it right there.
Are they gone? I don't hear anything.
If you're referring to the giants, I took care of them.
They're dead?
Yep, thoroughly expired. They were no match for us. There's an older couple back there that could use some help, though.
That must have been Oneida and her husband, Gian. Thank you. We'll send help right away.
So you're saying you just happened to show up at the right time, huh?
I suppose.
Interesting coincidence.
If you're suggesting I had something to do with this attack...
Whoa, take it easy. I have to apologize for my big friend Calum here. We're just a little overwhelmed is all.
What's been happening here?
I guess you missed the endless hordes of bloodthirsty monsters on your way in?
They used to stay in the mountains, away from the village. Now, they're attacking us on a daily basis. No one's been hurt yet, at least not until today. If giants are showing up near Oneida's farm, things are far worse than we thought.
Speaking of which, where exactly do you come from? There's nothing west of here except crazy old Cora.
We're...
Prospectors! We are prospectors! And we're out on an excavation to find, ore deposits in the mountains. You know, gold, silver, manganite?
Prospectors, eh? You're certainly well-armed for the job.
Like you said, there are a lot of monsters out there.
Well, we're indebted to you either way, so go on through. But I'm watching the two of you.
Please, make yourselves at home. My name is Bean. There's not much here, but we do have a merchant if you need supplies.
Thank you. We'll be on our way then.
Hey, you interrupted my outro. Well, I might as well find my way to a...
Fidgets, that was the best thing you could come up with.
It was the first thing that popped into my head. It's not like you had anything better. Come on, let's get away from these guards.
All right, Ara. Where to now?
You're right where you need to be. The answers to your identity lie somewhere in this village.
I know this place, and that's for certain. I'm sure I've been here before, but nobody seems to recognize me.
And you, in turn, do not recognize them. Yet I feel there is something here that may get triggered when you return.
Maybe we should look around for a Bigfoot? If you really have been here before, maybe somebody will recognize you.
That is a good idea, Fidget. Let us meet with the townspeople. I am certain that the next step of your journey will reveal itself in time.
Very well, but something here is making me uneasy. Like the calm before a storm.
Huh. I wonder if they had issues with the sound mixing in this draft of the game, because the, everything sort of sounds weird. Like, that rain seems weirdly loud to me. Did I get another skill gem? I did. Defense makes sense. I might as well make my way to a save point. I'm pretty sure there's one here in town. I'll talk to you later, buddy. Or maybe. Leave me alone. I'm just trying to find your save point. You guys have save points, right? Maybe they don't have a save point. How do you guys live without a save point? I think that there might be one up... Oh, wait, no, I think the...
Hey there!
Well, hello. You're a quiet one.
Dust, manners. You'll have to excuse him. He's a bit worn out, saving the village and everything, you know?
Yes, I heard something about that.
Ah, yes. Well, good.
Honestly, it doesn't matter. They'll just keep coming back. And there's nothing we can do about it. Excuse me.
It's a bit of a pessimist, isn't she, Miss Ginger? Come to think of it, I think the save point's actually underground.
Careful one, huh?
A bit of gratitude might have been nice. What kind of a bratty...
Hey, ease off, Dust. She looked like she was pretty depressed.
I don't know why I said that. I'm sorry, Fidget. I don't know what came over me just then. Come on, let's keep moving.
He's getting flashes of character in there. I think the save point actually is underground, if I remember correctly. So, the thing about Dust is he doesn't remember who he is, but as you start playing this game, you start getting more and more evidence that maybe the person he was wasn't all that great of a person. As shown by that prologue that seems to infer that Dust might have been some kind of crazy warmonger. Hello, treasure. Happy to oblige. And heal a bit, apparently. Alright, maybe the next screen has the save point. I figure I might as well find a save point before I stop. But we get more and more implication, as shown by the prologue and these random bursts of not-so-great emotion, that Dust, before he lost his memory, might not have been the best person. I did mention there was elements of genocide and all that. So, is there a save point? I think it might be down here. I think there's a challenger room over here. Because this game had... Yep, there we go. Here's our save point. So, thanks for guys for watching, like always. This has been our first ever sponsored video for Seth Kane's. Go to the Patreon page if you want to see how that goes. Patreon.com/SebastianSB. People who support me on certain tiers can actually ask me to play pretty much any game that I own or games I can reasonably acquire for an hour each. The original game, of course, was Five Nights at Freddy's 4, but that didn't go so great for a full hour episode, so he was accommodating with the idea of switching to this game, and this worked out just fine. So I'm happy with how this is going. In the future, we'll probably stick to one game for the entire episode. I don't expect this kind of complication to arise that often, but in this case, I felt like the episode overall was probably going to go better if I switched to something else. So we communicated and we figured it out. Thanks for watching, guys. Like always, thank you for the support, and I'll see you next time.